Hello everybody, welcome to another CSGO editing tutorial. In this tutorial, I'm going to show you how to change the shadows on CSGO maps. It's pretty easy to do as it only requires a couple commands and it just makes the game look a little bit different. So first up, what you need to do is head over to advancedeffects.org and download the latest version of HLE. The latest version is in this green box, just download and install that. After you have that installed, just open up HLE, go to File, Launch CSGO. The csgo.exe file, just click browse and then locate your csgo.exe. This will be wherever you have your game installed. So I have it mine on my separate e-drive. You can enter the directory for your Boomerang config here. And for graphic resolution, you can enable this and use a custom resolution. And after that, you can pretty much leave everything default and just click launch. All right, so once the game is launched, you should just close the console and you should see this valve enter cheat message pop up. That means HLE is working. Just press OK. Press Shift F2 on your keyboard to bring up the demo UI. And just go ahead and load into a demo. Alright, so once you're in your demo, you can pretty much just skip to any rounds. Doesn't really matter. And just go into third person mode. And I'm just going to go to the camp path mode. Just so you can see the full map like so. Alright, once you've gotten to a point where you can actually see the full map, like so, I'm just going to hide the HUD like that, and then what you need to do is type merv underscore cvar unhide all, and after you type that, type csgo underscore quality level 3, make sure that is set to level 3, that way you get the best quality. Then after that, type csgo underscore csm underscore rot override 1, and you can already see the shadows have changed on the map. Like so, and then you can go ahead and mess around with that by changing the X, the Y, and the Z axes. I'm just going to change the X to like 35 or so, and as you can see, it is changed like that. If you wish to see the difference, just type, just change the override command to 0, and there you go, you can see the difference already. Just makes the game look a little different. So you can pretty much mess around with it. You can probably also change the skybox to something a bit nicer. Something like that maybe. To make it fit a bit better. Like so. So that's pretty much it. Just need to mess around with the axes depending on how you want the game to look. That's pretty much it. Hopefully you found this tutorial helpful. Thanks for watching, and I'll see you all in the next one.